of course, we've got a byproduct that essentially means that our operating cost, even though the upfront capital cost is slightly higher than competitor projects, our operating cost as a result of the byproduct will be very low compared to our competitors.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Braam Jonker. He is the Chief Financial Officer for centurylithiumcorp. And Braam, great to see you. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Thanks a lot, Steve. And thanks for having me this morning.
Yeah, I'm excited to talk about some news that the company had out. You know, you released reports on your Angel Island project, and we'll talk about what it is in just a second, you know, back in April. And part of the process is you look at all the numbers and maybe look at cost efficiencies. And that's where this email, this news release rather, comes out today and talking about how you feel that you can drop almost 25% of the CapEx in that particular project. So let's begin with the project itself. Remind everyone about Angel Island.
Yeah, so Angel Island is an advanced lithium project out in Nevada in the US. So we have already completed our feasibility study there. And as we've announced today, we have now also completed an optimization study, which is a fairly normal process as we advance the project. So we are not too far away from two other advanced projects that are further advanced than what we are also in Nevada. So we're in a very good neighborhood out there. And we certainly believe that this is a project that will become an operation one day.
So as I mentioned, up to 25% potential savings in phase one. So give me some thoughts on some of the areas where you see the biggest opportunity for cost savings.
Yeah, so the bulk of those cost savings is going to be in the processing plant. So what we've essentially done is we've looked at this entire project, and it's a three-phase project, right? So we were only focusing on phase one. You know, some of these cost savings may or may not even reoccur in phase two and three as well, right? But what we've essentially done is we took the feasibility study from A to Z and reviewed everything, and the pilot plant was up and running till recently. We're now using it as a demonstration plant. So we did a lot of further testing on the processing side. So the bulk of those savings that you see will actually come out of the processing facilities.
Yeah, and that's a big part of this is the ability to generate revenue while you're doing that as well in order to offset costs also. So there's a bit of pull on both sides of it, which is interesting.
Yes. Yeah, so what we also have, of course, we've got a byproduct that essentially means that our operating cost, even though the upfront capital cost is slightly higher than competitor projects, our operating cost as a result of the byproduct will be very low compared to our competitors, which is really a big advantage for us, and I think something that's mainly overlooked by the market for whatever reason. But that's something that I think people should start taking note of. It will form about one third of our revenue stream going forward. So that's a fantastic position to be in for a company like ourselves.
Absolutely. So now the process is you're going to take a look at this numbers, validate some of it, and then potentially put it into an update on the feasibility study?
Yes, that's correct. So the next step for us is to finalize what we've done. I mean, we've completed the optimization study. But, you know, now it's to really put pen to paper on that and to get an external consulting engineering firm to come in and validate that and put that into an updated feasibility study. And this is a fairly normal process. And you know, I wouldn't be surprised if there are even more savings found along the way. You know, this is the capital cost of all these great projects. Are on the higher side, so You know, so this is a fairly standard process for a project this size, is to go through it, and there will be significant cost savings. And like I said, this is only on phase one. We'll certainly be carrying these through to phase two and ultimately phase three as well. But the main focus at this point in time will be phase one and phase two, which will make us a fairly sizable lithium producer and a very competitive one as well.
Absolutely. Braam, thanks so much. Great to see you, and congratulations on the updates here. Very exciting, and we look forward to following the story, okay?
No, it's a great pleasure, and again, thanks for having me, and hopefully the investor market will take note of this. We are certainly moving this project in the right direction, and we are confident that in future this is going to be a very exciting project. Okay.
All right, Braam Jonker. He's the Chief Financial Officer for Century Lithium.